Hello everyone. The structural lines are removed before coloring the face. These are the some of the colors that will be used for the face. I am using a deep yellow color for the lightest tone as I am making an Indian girl. And if the girl is very fair, then you can use the light pink color for the light tone. The physical features vary from individual to individual. This is just a general idea. Some people have got big ears and some have small. Some have got very big eyes, some have got small eyes. The highlights are the lifted part of the face where the light falls directly. The medium tone I have taken is the brown color. As I said, the highlights will remain untouched. Black color I am using here for the dark tone. We can even use deep blue color for the dark tones. I am using pencil colors on cartridge paper. The highlights can also be covered with the lightest colors, light yellow, even deep yellow, pink, or even left blank and untouched as I am doing to give it a shine. The black color is used for the eyebrows, the eyelids, the eyeballs. And even the eyelashes. The red color can be used on the lips and even pink color. The black color the nostrils will be having, total deep black, even the center of the lips and the inside part of the ears especially. It's very important. Even carefully you can rub the outlines of the lips and ears with a rubber. With the pressure of your hand, you can change the tone of the hair. You can make the dark tone and light tones of the hairs just by changing the pressure of your hand with a black pencil only. If you stand little further away from the portrait, you can check whether your portrait needs little more of the light tone or not, and check whether the highlights are proper or are they too much. This is smudging done with the paper stump. This is the little bit of touching up you can also do after looking at the portrait from little far away. And if some shades are needed near the nose or not,